So let us proceed with the next talk. Semyon Nasirov from Kazan will speak about properties of level curves. Please.
First, I would like to thank the organizing committee for a kind invitation to take part in this very good conference. I would like to talk about some properties of an Abelian integral on three sheeted torus. This is a short description. The talk is devoted to application of complex story and elliptic function to some problem connected with Hermite-Padé approximations. We construct an Abelian differential with some definite properties and on three sheeted torus over the Riemann sphere and study level set of some harmonic function is connected with this Abelian differential and investigate fragmentation of the torus into three sheets. Because if we have a Riemann surface over the Riemann sphere, what is the sheet of the Riemann surface? It is not uniquely determined. We must cut along some maybe curves and then obtain sheets of complex plane and then glue them along these slits. And this fragmentation is so-called Natol structure. And this structure plays an important role in Hermite-Padé approximation. And I briefly recall some concepts of this diagonal Hermite-Padé approximation. This is if you have some holomorphic function M in a neighborhood of infinity, you know, like gems maybe, then the Hermite-Padé approximants are such rational functions certifying the following relation at infinity. If the function can be analytically convenient from infinity along any curve outside a fixed compact, then the important problem is to find the maximal domain of convergence of these approximants to the function. And in the case when we have only one function, m equal 1, the problem also by Stahl, and Stahl, these works, these papers, prove that this domain is the exterior of some compact. And the boundary of this compact K, he described with the help of orthogonal trajectories of some quadratic differential connected with the Green function of the exterior of K. And for the case of several functions, the problem is still open, is very difficult and interesting. And interesting is investigate the situation with the set of singular point E, the capital, is defined. And further, we will assume that this holds below. And Natol in 1984, he conjectured that asymptotics of this approximation is connected with some compact M plus one sheeted Riemann surface S covering the Riemann sphere. And the branch point lying over this exceptional set E. And he suggested to consider the following Abelian integral G on the compact Riemann surface. Is properties similar to maybe somewhat like a Green function, but it has not a unique singular point. But we have m plus 1 sheets of Riemann surface and m plus 1 infinite point, or point over the infinity on the complex, extended complex plane. And near this infinite point, we have the following asymptotics. P0, m logarithm z, and other points minus 1 logarithm z. So the total of the sum equals 0. And all the periods of G appear imaginary, and we can consider this real part of G is a single-valued harmonic function. And this function determine this Natol structure, defragmentation into sheets. This I recall this construction. We consider a point Z not lying in the exceptional set E, and there is m plus 1 point of S lying over this point Z, and we denote this Z 0, 1, and m. And denote j this the value of this harmonic function at the point zj. And we can enumerate arbitrarily, but we enumerate this point such that the following inequality hold. And for z with such, when all the inequalities are strong, then such numeration is determined by a unique way. And after that, we consider these sets in the complex plane, of the Riemann surface S, all the point P such that coincide with that G. And we call this SG the jth sheet of the Riemann surface S. And this is Natol construction, Natol defragmentation of a Riemann surface, and even if m equal 2, the number of points is not large, the problem is not fully investigated. No, for example, we can consider this case. We have two functions, f and f square. F is such product, only three points of singularity, a, j, this alpha j. And, the point pairwise distinct, and the number is not integer. But the problem instigates this situation for 3 points, and such problem was suggested by Suetin. And in the paper by Aptekarev and Tulyakov, the problem was investigated, after investigated the structure of this set, this gj equals gk, j not equal k, and it is very important the geometric structure of the triangle with vertices a1, a2, and a3. And In this paper, the authors investigated the case when this point form a triangle close to regular. Yes, правильный in Russian. This and by natural conjecture, the set, this set, attracts poles of Hermite-Padea rational approximants, and it also interesting to study this sets, this curves where the different sheets of Natol defragmentation glued along this curves, projection of these slits on the Riemann surface. It's very interesting and very important for application. And in this talk, we consider arbitrary points of pairwise distinct and investigate the problem for arbitrary triangle with these vertices here. So we the main idea is to construct a universal covering of this three sheeted Riemann surface, to construct a universal covering and to lift the desired Abelian integral on this universal covering, and to construct explicitly the Weierstrass elliptic function. To do that, we first, with the help of some Möbius transform T, we map this triangle, we map the three point at three point, which are the vertices of a regular triangle. This is unit, and this is a two point rotation by angle 2π/3±. And then we see that the infinite point are mapped onto some point W0, and this point shows how this triangle how much is different from a regular one. If this triangle is regular, then this point lie at the origin. And for example, if three points lie on the same straight line, then this point W0 lies on the boundary of this circle. So this, instead of investigation different triangles, we fix the triangle, but this point shows how the situation is far from regular. And then we have Riemann surface fixed of Riemann surface of this function. It is complex torus and genus equals 1. And it is a parabolic Riemann surface. And it can be uniformized by with the help of complex sphere without infinity, and we can use a doubly periodic function with some periods omega 1 and omega 2. And we can describe this universal covering in explicit form, for example, such maybe I draw. Got it. We have this construction three points and W0. And we map this construction onto the union disk, disk onto the regular triangle, such that the vertices, this 0, maybe 1, and this length equals 1. And then the point W0, this corresponds to infinity. It maps onto some alpha. So instead of the unit disk, we have a triangle, and then we continue analytically this function by symmetry, by Riemann-Schwarz principle, by symmetry onto the whole plane. So this we have hexagon, and this function can be expressed via elliptic function. Yeah. This is the construction, and we see this usually fundamental parallelogram is used. Here, this this point A, it is the same on the complex torus, the same point. But it's very convenient to use not a parallelogram, but a hexagon, fundamental hexagon, this. And it's very interesting. It is the fundamental domain for this covering. And there are 3 points over infinity, alpha, and also 2 points that obtained by rotation. This alpha, alpha maybe 1, alpha 2, it will remain alpha. And this is 3 points corresponding to infinities. And we, the help of this, this is a projection. It's this expressed via sigma phi function by Weierstrass, and this is inverse function. Inverse function. This with the help of Schwarz-Christoffel integrals. And this is very important theorem, how to how this Abelian differential on the Riemann surface, we find the lift of this Abelian integral on the universal covering. On the universal covering, this is have a very explicit form. Here you see alpha, and this 2 point, alpha 1 and alpha 2. This corresponds to the infinite point. And also we have some additional summand. And this is the needed Abelian integral on the universal covering. Then we determine real part of this Abelian integral, this G tilde, and obtain description of the sheets of Natol decomposition of three sheets of Riemann. For example, the zero, the main sheet, this is described with the help of this inequalities. And other touches describe it with the help of the following. But more simple, to introduce the new function, it has only two singular points, not three, as Abelian integral, but only two point here, and this point, alpha 1 and alpha 2. And then we can describe the sheets of Natol decomposition in the theorem 2. If we consider these sets, L1, 2, L2, 1, and gamma is level zero level set for this harmonic function U, then we obtain the following description of these three sheets of Natol decomposition. So actually, we need to determine gamma 1, 2, the boundary between these two sets, and then we determine this L1, 2, L2, 1, and all the sheets. And you see, we also need to describe rotation, these sets, L1, 2, L2, 1, by some angle, 2 pi over 3, and minus 2 pi over 3. First, we investigate the where the critical points of the harmonic function U lie. And we prove that the equation has only two solutions, and in every fundamental domain. And if alpha is not lie in the center of the triangle, what here, if you have a regular triangle, then W0 lie at the center of the disk, and here alpha lie at the center of this triangle. If alpha is not at the center, then these two solutions are different. And if lie at the center, then they coincide. And I cited the paper by Aptekar and Turlyakov, and he investigated the case when alpha is close to the center of this triangle. And then we theorem 4 shows where the critical points lie on this set we are interested in gamma 1, 2, or not. And this critical point line on this set, if and only if either triangle is regular or triangle is isosceles with the angle at the vertex greater than pi over 3, or the point, 3 point at the initial situation lie on the same line. And here you I show this picture. Well, this is what alpha lie at the center, or these parts of heights of this triangle, or on the boundary of this triangle, except for these vertices, naturally. And now we consider the case when alpha is real. It is the triangle is isosceles here. And I describe how the situation change when we go along this segment. And first, we for alpha close real close to the origin, we have such situation. The set consists of lines of two kinds, real axis and all lines obtained by shifts along the lattice. Then when alpha grow, we at last obtain this situation. And then if alpha is greater than the position of the center, then there is a bifurcation and we obtain such geometric structure. And at last, when alpha here tends to this point, we obtain the tiling of the universe covering the plane by rectangles. It's very interesting situation. I show once more. First this one, then we obtain this tiling by regular triangles, then this situation, and at last we have such picture. And if alpha is not real, but not on the side, we, for example, no, this is this picture correspond to this situation when alpha lie on this side of triangle, and then we have such situation. And when alpha is not real, then the picture is topologically is the same as for this, and not exceptional case. This
please
case.
Notice that time for questions starts.
What?
Time for questions already starts.
Oh, okay, okay. Maybe I one minute I finish this situation, but then we I would like to show this conjecture from numerical calculation. This conjecture appeared, and from this conjecture follows the full description. And only I want to say that Sergei Suetin informed me recently that Alexander Komlov published in archive a result from here the validity of this conjecture follows, and then we if this true, then we can draw this sheath. I only at final I only show the pictures very quickly. This is alpha real close to zero. Then this situation, this is SGF sheets, not all sheets on the universal covering. And here this when alpha not on the sides of triangle, and here with 3 points aligned on the same line. Here the it's very interesting that the sheet S zero is disconnected. It's have two components. It's very interesting, and unexpected for me. And this is the structure on the not on the universal covering, but on the plane, on the plane. Well, thank you very much for attention.
We have time for one question, if there is any. No. I don't see. Ah. Okay. Please.
I saw a plot.
Okay, thank you very much. We have a coffee break.